Math allows us to estimate numbers. We use math in our life every time we go shopping to estimate how much our groceries are going to cost, and of course totals the correct amount when we go to the checkout.
We use math to measure things. When we cook, we need math to measure things correctly and ensure we have correct quantities of each ingredient.
Technology plays a major part in our lives. We use math and technology when we bake, to weigh and measure ingredients and set oven temperatures.
Milk, butter, eggs, and cake mix.
The cake mix costs $2, the milk costs $1, the eggs cost $1, and the butter costs another $1. That'll be $5, please.
Would you like a receipt?
Yes, please.
Here you go.
Thank you.
That'll be $9.90, please.
Really? I thought it cost $5.
No, because even though the cake is on sale, it's still $3. The eggs are $3, the milk is $3, and the butter is 90 cents.
Oh, okay. Here you go.
Would you like a receipt?
Yes, please.
And here's your change.
Thank you.
Okay.
Bye. This is what will happen if we don't have math in our lives. We wouldn't be able to calculate the prices for our ingredients correctly, and we wouldn't have the correct amount of money to pay for our groceries.
Hey Charlotte, would you like some help?
Yes, please. Can you get the eggs for me?
Sure. How many?
Two, please.
Okay. Here you go.
Thank you. And can you get me 2/3 of a cup of milk, please?
Here you go.
Thank you.
Hey Charlotte, would you like some help?
Yes, please. Could you get some eggs?
Sure, how many?
I think it was 3.
Okay. Hey, are you sure it was 3 eggs?
Sorry, it was 2 eggs actually. Could you get a cup of milk as well, please?
Are you sure it's a cup of milk?
Sorry, it was actually 2/3 of a cup of milk.
Here you go.
Thank you.
The reality is, if that Charlotte puts in too much milk and too many eggs, the cake mix will be too runny, and the cupcakes won't turn out as expected.
You're right, Millie. I shouldn't put too much eggs and milk in the mixture.
That's all right, Charlotte.
It says we need to use 60 grams of butter.
I have this 250-gram block of butter. It has a 50-gram mark, so if I just go a little bit further, it should be 60 grams.
Perfect! It's 60 grams.
It says we're supposed to use 60 grams of butter.
I have this 250-gram block of butter. It has a 50-gram mark. If I cut it a little bit further, it should be 60 grams.
It's only 50 grams.
What should we do? Should we try and add another 10 grams?
Yeah, because it's important to follow the recipe. Great, it's now 60.
When we bake, we use math and technology. If we didn't, we wouldn't get the right amount of ingredients.
Our world desperately needs math. We use it every day.
As our example showed, by simply baking a cupcake, we used math in shopping, cooking, and in our technology.
Our scenarios also show skills used that math teaches us: estimation, calculation, measuring, weight, and application of maths.
Math is often overlooked, as people don't realize how many times we use math. So to all the math haters, we hope you now understand why the world needs math. It can result in yummy cupcakes.